Приветствую, братья и сестры. Welcome, everybody. Today's my topic. My topic is love. So, not because Valentine's Day just passed, but because we see and use this word quite often. So, love is a word that we use in many ways. Like, I love coffee, I love French fries, and I love this TV show. But if we take a moment to stop and consider the word love, all the other loves really do fall short. So what exactly is love? Stated in 1 Corinthians chapter 13, verse 4 and 5, love is patient, love is kind. It does not envy, it does not boast. It is not proud, it does not dishonor others. It is not self-seeking, it is not easily angered. It keeps no record of wrongs. So what we can understand is that through Christ, he may be formed in us so that we are able to love as he loves. For his love is patient and his love is kind. And with this, we must understand that kindness is noted as a part of the fruit of the Spirit. Living a life of love marked by kindness is one aspect of living in a way that pleases God. And Deuteronomy chapter 6, verse 5 states, love the Lord your God with all your heart and with all your soul and with all your strength. This explains to us that we should never put anything above the Lord and never love your desires above the Lord. But some may ask, how do we love? Well, in 1 John chapter 4, verse 18 and 19, there is no fear in love, but perfect love drives out fear, because fear expects punishment. The one who fears is not made perfect in love. We love because he first loved us. When we experience God's love in our lives and share it with others, we do not need to fear, and we don't need to fear about love, the judge or the hurt. So the punishment, the one-on-one relationship we have with God flourishes that God's love in our lives gives us the confidence and security which leads us to the ability to live out his love in all ways possible. So when we have this love, we should know that it shouldn't be forced or be something to be worried about, but it should be cherished and it should be as wonderful and warming like a hug. So what we can learn from this is that God's love is everlasting, and what you can look anywhere and everywhere, but you will never find his love purer than how much God loves us. Amen.